All right, the recording has started. So, good afternoon, everyone. So, welcome. This is a session for Felix internship graduation presentation. Woo! Yay! Okay, so... Okay, thank you, Felix. So, Felix is our business data scientist intern in Bukit Vista, and he has finished his internship, his 3 months internship. And here he will be presenting about his legacy, basically. What did he do during his internship? What are the projects? What are the learnings, takeaways, as well as some extra tips, perhaps from Felix for future interns later on, or even like our current interns in Bukit Vista. And okay, before that, let me introduce myself as well as the few people here present in the room. My name is Shelin, and I am here as the moderator for this event. And we have quite a few people, yeah, in the room. I believe most of the people here are from the BI team, especially. And we also have some people from even from the other team in this case. So just a quick one in this case, because there's a lot of people, yeah. So we have Bella, Farhan, Jovanka, Lila, Marcel, Maria Lydia, Lilis, Raffi, Rifki, and Vidi from the BI team. And we also have Gray from the reservation team, Nadine from the business development team as well. And hopefully I don't miss out anyone, yeah, in this case. Hopefully not. If I do miss anyone, please notify me so that I can introduce you. All right. Then, yeah, there will be the quick introduction for those attending to this meeting. So, okay. Now, let's go to the main event then. So, for the presentation itself, let us go to Felix. And, yeah. Silakan, Bapak okay. Felix.
Okay, thank you, Kak Shell. It's been a long time, yeah, everyone, from the 1st of June until 18th of September. Okay, let's start my internship graduation presentation. So let me introduce myself first. I'm Felix Ivander Ganumba. I was an electrical engineer. Now I'm a data scientist. Also, I was quite insecure before back then, before I joined BV, but now it's a bit less. So yeah, that's a good thing. I was an introvert. Now I think sometimes I'm still an introvert, sometimes I'm not. Yeah, I'm still confused on that. Also, I was a sad and lonely boy, I think. Now I'm so happy. Why? Because I met all the nice people in Bukit Vista. Yay! Okay. So let's start. So what I did in Bukit Vista, it can be divided into 3 operational work, projects, and others. Let's start first from operational work. So in the first 3 weeks in BV, I was placed in reservations team. So the task was to reply to various kinds of inquiries on Airbnb, ManyChat, Booking.com, etc. Also making sure the guests are having fluid and seamless experience when booking. As you can see on the slides, it's one of the example that my reply to inquiries on Airbnb. Yeah. Next one, it's HOO mini projects. So during HOO, which was 3 weeks, I did some of projects. I guess I can call it mini projects because it's quite small. One of it is optimizing shift arrangement tables. I don't have the before after tables. I only have the after one. So that is the first picture on the above. The second one is creating curated recommendations on places to go to according to area on Koda. So I have made the list according to each area. Like for one area that it will have like 3 to 4 recommendations on places to go. And then afterwards, Lila and the others implemented it on scheduled message on Airbnb, so it's automated. So thank you, Lila, for that. Afterwards, I did operational work, SPP data integrity. It was quite tiring, to be honest, but it's worth it, I think. The first one is I'm the inspector, and also I'm the executor for unit for all the four categories, which are units and listing, cancellation data on booking database, and also owner block format on Talkit, and also Talkit versus bigger data integrity. The background to check and to inspect and execute it is for unit and listing is to make sure the Talkit and bigger and our unit allocation is correct. And also for the cancellation data, it's to gain better insights accuracy. So the cancellation data is correct, therefore we can gain better insights from that. For owners who are on Talkit, it's to ensure owner is following the policy that we made for the format of owner block. So we don't confuse ourselves with owner booking. So yeah, for the next one, it's Talkit versus bigger data integrity. It's because Talkit and bigger, because it's sometimes a different system, because there will be differences in terms of data. So why do we check it? It's because if we want to make sure the accuracy on past bookings, particularly revenue, is correct, and also for the future bookings, we want to make sure that the booking is there in Talkit. It exists in Talkit and also in bigger. Afterwards, I optimize some things in SPP data integrity, like making the code run faster by replacing for loops with df.it rows, which will for loop each row on the data frame. I made it into slicing with conditions, so it's faster. We just put like a condition and it will output the same thing. Also, I added a way to mark already inspected blocks that can't be changed to be the same on Talkit and bigger by adding it on block title, so it's easily filtered out. Afterwards, we develop it again. As we don't use hot events anymore, we added code on the script to get inspected keywords from booking notes with help from my mentor, Kofidi. As a result, the code block for getting the calendar and notes takes 30 minutes to run. So I added async functions with async IO and AIO HTTP that reduces runtime for the block to under 30 seconds. So from 30 minutes, it becomes under 30 seconds. For other operational work that I do, I usually create queries which will result in visualizations on Data Vista. So I took two samples from all the queries that I've made. Why did I choose this one? The uppermost one, number of people in a reservation name over period of time, I think it's a bit hard because of the integrating it with Google Sheets. And also for the below one, it's comprehensive monthly occupancy rate. I think it's the hardest one that I've ever made here. So yeah. Afterwards, I did property revenue projections. I make property revenue projections by request from BD team. And also I forecast the ADR, occupancy rate, and revenue with help from Bella. And also I make digestible and easy to understand charts for property owners. And also we have a future projects for this, which is intelligent property management. Afterwards, another operational work that is quite fun to me, yeah, it's fixing faults in data and anomalies. So human errors aren't rare. It's quite often. There are always data to be fixed. Some data that I have fixed include booking earn. Like sometimes the booking earn is too big, sometimes it's too low. So I check it and I make sure the data is correct. Another example is guest size. As you can see from the below one, the below picture, it's booking guest, the bottom picture, it's booking guest number. No way that the guest is booking for 2 million person. Yeah, so I fixed that. And also I found that some bookings are missing. Therefore, I created the bookings, and also there are some owner data that I need to fix. So I collaborate with Royhan from BD, and also I need help from Kofidi from BD from PD to fix the database, and also CM to make sure the data is correct. Another project that I made is overbooking detector. Overbookings are quite problematic and they take a lot of time and energy to resolve. Therefore, I created a notification system for a portion of overbooking cases. There were a lot of limitations regarding database and how to mark it as inspected, but with Google Sheets, it's solved. From the left picture, you can see that it's already deployed on Slack channel OB detector. And also, I need a dynamic database. On the right one, I use Google Sheets to track which booking that I have sent recently. So the overbooking detector doesn't send it repeatedly for the next upcoming days. I iterated the OB detector for like 3 times. The first time it was only a query on Data Vista, so there was no Slack notification. For the second iteration, I added Slack notification, and then I sent all the lists for 3 days ahead, but there are some repeating messages. So it's quite noisy for the OB detector. For the third iteration, I eliminate the repeating messages by adding Google Sheets as dynamic and temporary database. And also I added ways to mark inspected on OB cases. And also I added automatic scenario to delete OB cases from Google Sheets. So the tools that I used to create this system is Data Vista and also Make or Integral Mat, and also Slack and Google Sheets. For the next projects, I made available unit search. Finding recommendations for alternative properties are wasting a lot of time, especially when we don't have property knowledge. It's something I did a lot during my time in reservations team. We had to go back and forth between Bigger and Tokit when we want to find alternative properties in the same area that is available on a given date. So it is already deployed, but it needs some improvement because of Tokit and Bigger differences in terms of data. So we need a way to connect Tokit rentals and also unit on Bigger with a key. So it's all of them are connected. As of right now, the available unit search only shows the data that only shows a portion of property that is fulfilling the requirement because some properties aren't detected because of differences in Tokit and also Bigger. So in this case, I use Tokit and also database. I use Python script and also deployed it on Flask server, and also I showed it on Redash or Data Vista. For the next one, I made a priority playlist for dynamic pricing. For listing level, based on Tokit's NAB or next available blocks, and formula related to number of available days and runways, I have made the priority playlist. However, it still needs improvement as the formula needs some tuning, and we have plans to make it NAB level instead of listing level. For the next one, I tested some channel manager software. Like I have arranged the meetings and also research about different channel managers and tested a few scenarios, like making a booking, making a cancellation, special offer, etc. The channel manager includes Scoutbeds, Sideminder, Little Hotelier, Logify, Guesty, and Nextpacks. For the other thing that I did in Bukit Vista is I'm the host of Happy Hour with Bella. It was my first happy hour, so I was quite shocked and awkward, but it was fun. I think it was successful. For the next one is host of BI Fun Day with Lila. It's so fun that I can't stop thinking about it. So yeah, the things that I have learned in BV. For the first one is it's time management with Google Calendar. As you can see, it's quite packed. Sometimes there are blocks that I made during the dusk because sometimes I'm a night person, so I do most of my work there. But it's usually in the morning or afternoon. For the next one, another thing that I have learned in BV, I think my SQL skill before I joined BV was quite mediocre. I I can only do simple queries, but thanks to Kofidi, he has trained me a lot on SQL. I have successfully, I think my skill on SQL is kind of improving. As you can see on the left one, it's a comprehensive occupancy rate query. I think it's the hardest one that I've ever made. Yeah, so that's why I showed that one. For the next one, I learned about async functions. Before Bifi, I rarely use async function. I usually use multiprocessing, but right now I use async functions to fasten the code and HTTP requests up from 30-ish minutes to under 20 seconds. So it's much more faster. For the next one, it's getting data from endpoints, which we extract from browser step tools. Kofidi trained me on this one, and I think it's a really cool technique to learn for us data scientists or IT skills that everyone, I think it's quite useful. Yeah. Another thing that I have learned is more complex fast RESTful code. Before Bifi, I use one file script for my Flask server, but in Bivy we separated per file. So that in Bivy I learned a lot about separating the code, the Flask code, into several files. And also I learned about querying from SQL Alchemy. Afterwards, I learned about using make or integromat. Also inspecting the history of errors if there is something that is need to be inspected. And also finally, I understand more about webhooks. To future interns, I think there's something that I need to say. Like for the first one, it's ask. If there's someone, there's always someone to help you. Don't be afraid to ask. And also the second one is there will be always be change, especially in startup like this. It's a good thing to have a change, because otherwise there wouldn't be innovations. For the next one, it's better to fail fast rather than doing nothing at all. So yeah, for the next slide, I want to say thank you to everyone. For the first one, it's my coolest mentor, I think. It's Kofidis Q. Sometimes I call him KopiDQ. Yeah, for the next person, it's my sister in tech, Jess. Next one, it's my second mom, Bella. Next one, it's Kak Lilis, my cute lecturer, and also my bestie, Lila, who always gossips about me. And also Kak Bayu, if he's here, you're scary, but you are so cool, I think. But I think you are really kind and friendly. Yeah, just a bit scary at first. And also the man, the myth, and the legend, Mr. Jing, which inspires me every day. He always thinks of new ideas every single day. And also my ex-supervisor, Nadine, who is really galak sometimes, I think. But yeah, she's really friendly. And also my support system, Giselle, who is always there to support me. And also another of my bestie, which is Farhan, who always teases me when he has the chance to do so. Yeah, so thank you everyone. Thank you Bukit Vista, and thank you for everything. Yeah.
Yay! Woo! Thank you Felix. Wah, tapi aku nggak disebutin ya, jadi so it's okay. It's okay. I'm not disappointed. It's okay. All right. Thank you Felix for the presentation. I see that there's a lot, like literally a lot of projects that you were working on. And it eventually helps the other team as well, in this case from the reservations team, from the partnership team, or even like the API team itself in this case. All right, nice. All right, since we do have quite a lot of people, yeah, in this session, so next I'll only like call maybe two of you only to like maybe share your experience, yeah, working with Felix in this case. Or if you have any comments, you can also like put it in the chat box as well, ya, gengs. So kalau misalnya nggak dapat kesempatan ngomong, bisa ngomong di chat box saja. All right. Okay, so let's see. We have quite a few people over here. So let's see, who should I choose here for this? Atau enggak dari Felix? Any request?
Coffee B.
Okay, Coffee B. Okay, Coffee B, maybe can tell us a little bit more, Nih.
Gak ada sound sih.
Covid ini gak ada suaranya. Okay. Maybe Covid ini
request dulu ya. Tak request dulu.
Okay then. Let's go to Lilis first in this case. Okay, Lilis, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I don't know. Ini kayaknya wifi gak lagging atau main internet ya.
Yep, it's all good.
Good. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, yes. So first, congratulations, Felix, for completing the internship. It's how many months? 3 and something, yeah?
3.5, gitu sih.
3.5. Yeah, so basically, at first, I don't really work with Felix like directly, karena lebih banyak ke data science, it was 3D actually. And we see from the beginning that Felix is very motivated in doing something, includes data science stuff and also operational stuff. So from that, we can see that might be Felix is fit with this company. Itu pertama kayak gitu. And then going to BI, he explores so many projects to help operation. Jadi benar-benar during doing the operation, I think he really thinks on how to make it more efficient. So that can be a good example for every one of you that doing the HOO and also would like to apply your roles. So you need to understand how we can help the operation become better or more valuable. Kalau misalnya you are a financial analyst, for example. And then coming to the end of his internship, he worked with me in the dynamic pricing together with the other team. And it's also very amazing that he can help me to find out a way, like how to prioritize the available nights, gitu ya. Which one we should take care first and second, etc. So it's also basically using his skills to help the operations in dynamic pricing. In conclusion, Felix, I'm not really sure if Felix signed the full-time contract or not. Yes? If yes, then yeah, I'll not promote him for the other company because he's joining us again. And I hope that he will enjoy the next role as a full-time, I think, data scientist here, junior atau apa gitu, I forget the roles. Basically, in data scientist, and I hope he can enjoy working here as there are so many things that we can improve in this company, especially when we are going to improve the dynamic pricing feature in our company to serve our partners. So congrats once again, Felix. You have done a great job. And I think you can be the role model for the next data scientist. Yay! Congrats!
Thank you, Kak Lilis.
Yeah. Mantap. Thank you, Lilis. Calon role model ya for the next interns, Felix.
Jeng is coming. Yang lain buka kamera lah.
Yeah.
Show your face, guys.
All right. Okay, thank you, Lilis. So, maybe Vidi, is your audio okay now?
Yes,
masuk. Okay.
Masuk ya.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, apologies. I think there's something. Yeah, it's been a while since we used it, whereby yeah. But I think the number of people that came to this IGP just shows how much Felix contributed to the company overall. not only on BI, but he actually has a lot of relations and also worked together with a lot of different departments, especially the hosting and also, I believe, the reservation previously. And just like what Liz mentioned, very high motivated and very hungry for a new experience. And one thing that is very, like, reminds me a lot with Felix is that he, if he feels like his job is not satisfying enough, he will speak up. He will say in Slack or maybe in, even in Google Calendar, that he doesn't enjoy doing the, like, repetitive job. So we need to give him more challenging things. But overall, I think an excellent example of an intern that have been transformed from the beginning until the end. For me, I work together with Felix in the technical aspect, and he's very he's a very fast learner. So I expect to see more great things from Felix during his employment in Bukit Vista. So thank you, Felix, and congratulations on your IGP.
Yeah.
Thank you, Poppy.
From the one and only mentor, ya. And now we have like two mentors nih in DS. Biasanya cuma Vivi aja kan. Sekarang ada Felix. Woo. Okay, nice. Upcoming mentor ya for the new data science interns in the future. Alright. Okay. So maybe apa an additional one from Mr. Jing, if you don't mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children, dogs and cats. Right about now, you are listening to the incredible drum patterns of DJ Manny. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a buy cars, I'm a get clothes, I'm a rock jewels, I'm a long flow.
All right, that's how I feel about Felix. We need him in our lives. I think a lot has already been spoken by Lilith already, so probably not too much to add. In a nutshell, I'll just repeat a little bit of the history we had with Felix, okay? So Felix, maybe unbeknownst to you, at the time you joined Bukit Vista, we were having serious load balancing issues with the operations and the data scientists and the BI team and the technical teams, okay? So we seem to be very good at recruiting people with business background or with data science backgrounds, business analyst backgrounds and such, but we're struggling to find operational people. So we came up with a new plan and it worked beautifully. With you, Leela, and the first generation of people under the new HOO program. And I think part of it was you approached with exactly what we're looking for in Bukit Vista, which is growth mindset, bias to action, and self-learning. I think you represent a lot of the best attributes of Bukit Vista, and I can see as a company that wants to innovate, your youthful qualities add a lot of energy, and they add a lot of inspiration to where we want to go. Never have I seen Felix approach uncertainty with anything less than a smile and this good to go determination. And I think that's very inspirational because so many times when we face uncertainty, we become scared, we turn off, we disengage, but I think Felix likes to engage. Felix patrols the company looking for problems, looking for where he can actually help out. I'm sure maybe Vidi has something to also do with that inspiration, as that's Vidi's approach to his work here at Bukit Vista as well. And so what I see is Felix is a model citizen of what we should be looking for in a hospitality innovation company, a person who has one foot very much thinking about user experience, thinking about how guests and partners will experience our services, but another foot also very deeply in technical knowledge and understanding capacity and solving deep difficult problems. So that's what I see in Felix. And of course, we've extended our offers to Felix to work here full time because we want Felix to build incredible experiences for millions of guests in the future, which will be hosted by Bukit Vista, hopefully. And we probably wouldn't get there without people like Felix coming in on board. So I have nothing but the highest of praise. In so many different levels, I think at a certain point, whatever we do technically needs to connect with the human side, and Felix does that really well. And the spirit of approaching new particular horizons is something you do pretty well. And I think you can lead all of us in that emotional well-being too as well, right? So I'm really happy to be here. I've got a few other things I gotta do right now, but I really wanted to see this particular moment. I'm really proud of you, Felix. Thank you for being part of Bukit Vista, and may you be part of Bukit Vista for many more years to come, decades to come, centuries to come, yeah, millennium to come. So, all right, that's my two cents on this. Back over to Shilin.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. Jing,
for your for making your time as well to attend for this presentation. Yeah. All right. Okay. Maybe before we end the session, I'll give it back to Felix then. Felix, is there anything else you would like to say from your side?
That's one thing, see, Kak Siel. I am really thankful that I stumbled across Bukit Vista when I scrolled Instagram one day in a morning, something like that. I scrolled through, I see Bukit Vista is opening a job listing to find a data scientist. However, I didn't feel qualified at that time, so I applied 1 year after that moment. I think everyone shouldn't be feeling like they aren't qualified. If they feel aren't qualified, I think it's better to like give it some time for you to improve. Like not as long as me, like 1 year or something. It's better to be like 1 week to improve yourself and everything. Don't feel insecure and such things. So yeah, for everyone who is looking at applying at Bukit Vista, I think just try it. Just worry later and try it first. Yeah. For everyone in Bukit Vista, I am really thankful because you guys have teach me a lot of things. Like I have learned a lot here, especially regarding hospitality management, company and some sort. Yeah. I just want to say thank you, and I apologize if I make some mistakes or something like that. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, nice. A new quote of the day, Felix. Try now, worry later. All right, nice. Thank you, Felix. So yeah, by that would end our session today for Felix internship graduation presentation. So I'd like to thank everyone as well who have come for this session and watched this video. And yeah, that's all, peeps. Have a nice day ahead.